representing the Bay Area of Northern California here in the Shark Tank, it's the San Jose Sharks. Hi, everybody. Along with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro is coming up. I'm Mike Emmerich. And tonight, we get to see the top team in the league. Wonder what it's like to coach the best team.
Well, why wouldn't you, Doc? You certainly want to be standing behind that bench, but there are some challenges because you know the opposition is going to bring their best. They know that we're playing really well. They don't want to get embarrassed. So I think the challenge is to continue to get the focus from your team, play the way that you have, but understand is that you're going to have to bring your work boots here tonight to have any chance in winning this game.
Edmonton's coaching staff has prepared them extremely well. Regardless of the situation, they never change. If they're up a goal, down a goal, they stay with their same game plan and adjust accordingly. That's why they're on top of the league standings.
Let's look at the starting netminders. Gave his team a chance to win last time, so he's out there this time. Incredibly strong performance with a shutout last time, so he gets the chance to keep that streak going. The centermen are in, and the puck will be dropped. Couture's the starting center for the Sharks. Neely's his opposite number for the Oilers. We've been looking forward to this, and so it unfolds right beneath us.
Edmonton's on fire. Another game, another win. They're making it look almost too easy right now, Doc.
That puck's loose. He couldn't get through the roadblock. He wore that puck on a hard shot. Got it back. Oh, what a hit. And there isn't enough set. Here they go.
Oh, that was not a good hit at all. Now somebody's coming to the aid of the fallen teammate.
There's really no reason for these guys to be dropping the gloves so early except to try and set the tone for their team tonight. This is going to be a physical game, and both guys want to inject their energy into the game here, and they'll do that with a good old-fashioned tilt.
Well, these guys will have 5 minutes to get back dressed and get ready to go again at some point.
Win that faceoff. Got it at the point. Fires. They score! Wow, that's getting on the board fast. Edmonton's ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge. And they take that neutral zone faceoff. A shot. He scores!
Great shot off the back, and he lights the lamp.
Man, he played that funny. He didn't even get his stick over into position to help with the stop. He might as well not have one.
A little under 4 minutes have passed. The Oilers are ahead 2-0. Edmonton's prevailed again on the faceoff of the neutral zone. Shot! Score! He's got his second!
People chasing him down on a breakaway, but he found a way to score.
Jones doesn't make the stop here. It's a low stick side shot that beats him pretty cleanly.
The Oilers get it off the faceoff.
By number 74, assisted.
Save. Take it to the slot.
What a heavy hit.
Looks like he arrived at the rink in a bad mood. Maybe
score! That is point number 200 this year.
An impossible. incredible feat, Doc. 200 points in a single season. The numbers don't lie in any era.
They've got the draw.
Scored by number 27.
Shoots. Big point blank save there.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop. He's been on fire tonight. Two goals already. His teammates would love to see him get that HT, Doc.
Now it's directed to Pavelski. Intercepts that pass on the attack. They're getting ready to strike. Rockets one. And a save. He covers and has defused the attack for now.
The Oilers look to him for a lot of their offense. He's one of the highest goal scorers in the league. He's dangerous on the power play, and he's really got a quick release.
First period is over. A dominant period for one of the teams. Repair for the other. We turn to the shots on goal. Heavy for one, light for the other. 22 for Edmonton and 1 for the Sharks. San Jose's goaltender has had one of those nights, and so this score is lopsided, and we will return after he gets a rest and these words. Second period about to begin here. Let's take a look back at the first. What stuck out for you?
The Sharks are trailing on the scoreboard because their time on attack was limited. They'll need to push the pace if they want to score more goals.
Second period is underway. Let's see if we get more of the same that we got in the first. Or maybe not. That puck struck him in front. He's right in. Just missed the net with that one.
From that position on the ice, he's got to hit the net.
Score! He's got the hat trick. And listen, the only ones you can hear are his teammates.
Thankfully, that shot did not hit the goaltender because that thing was labeled.
Oh, did he ever lay into that one? You don't have enough time most of the time to shoot a slap shot. He had enough there, and he absolutely pounds it.
Edmonton's hammered home yet another goal. They've got a lot of shots, and now they've got goals to show for their effort. And they've won the faceoff. And angle to Neely. Terrific work with the glove. Couldn't keep it, though. With a blast! Score! That's the hat trick. There won't be many on the ice, if any, but he's got three goals. Edmonton's won that faceoff at the neutral zone. Fires. He scores. Neely.
No chance stopping that puck with the quick release.
I think if the goaltender's a little more patient here, Eddie, stays up on his feet, he's going to be able to make the save. But when he drops into the butterfly, that opens up that top glove hole.
Edmonton's got a large lead in this game. Let's see if they can build on it or whether they'll start to get conservative. And that's a face-off win. And at an angle, he scores! Another one!
Quick release on that snapshot. No way he's going to miss from the low slot.
That looks like it almost went right through him, Edzo. Just above the pad, he's in the butterfly. It's on the low glove side. It's a save, a goal he should make.
Edmonton's got an enormous lead, and it's in the second period.
Hopefully they don't go daydreaming now.
Another good job in the faceoff circle. One of many today. What a percentage he's got. He's right in front with it. Terrific point blank save.
That is a great display of goaltending there, Doc.
That puck is held and the whistle stops play.
Edmonton's team leans on him for offensive production. They need him to score on the power play. They need him to score 5-on-5. And he's delivered all season long as he's among the highest points totals in the league. Have dominated this game right from the very beginning. Their goalie has been good. Their defensive play has been solid. They've been physical and skated well. The coaches can be nothing but thrilled.
Shoots! Outstanding save. What magic even to get there and get the shot off.
Equal to the challenge. Nice stop.
One word of advice. When you're pushing and shoving like that, you better be ready to drop the gloves.
Kane's goal. Look out here. What do you think?
He's asking and looking for a dance partner.
Edmonton's physical play opens up the ice for them all over the place. This player has among the highest hit totals in the league. Very valuable, although he's not a big scorer.
The Oilers get the draw. And for sure, the task is taken here.
Oh, that was not a good hit at all. Now somebody's coming to the aid of the fallen teammate.
Sure why they'd accept this fight up so much. Weidman's been in discomfort since this hit here.
Nice face-off win. Slides it to the point. Wow, what a hit. What a means. Okay, so we got a guy hurt here, and it looks like a fight's gonna start.
And that is one way to respond after you have an injured teammate.
And out of all of this, both receive fighting majors.
These games don't come along very often anymore where they're chippy, aggressive, over the line a lot of times with way too many penalties.
Those guys have been eyeing themselves up all night long. They're going to get a chance to look at each other from the penalty box for 5 minutes.
The Oilers, wow, that's got to be a call, that's got to be a penalty, and that's got to be an answer from the other team.
Kane's nicked up here, but he can't get off the ice. He's going to have to wobble away.
We've got a guy down, and gloves are going to go down.
You don't like seeing injured players on the ice, but I love the response of his teammates.
And this fight has ended with one last solid punch.
Great hands for not only scoring, but also knocking out his opponent. Much safer up here with you, Doc, in the booth. 5 minutes for fighting for those guys.
The Oilers win it. Flings it. Well, they got to be a little tired after these first two periods of play, so they'll get a rest as we start to think ahead toward period number three. All right, time to turn to the shots on goal and look at some impressive totals. 43 for the Oilers and 6 for the Sharks.
Every playoff game, our team score brings you our item of the game.
Weidman's bad injury here is going to cost the team his services for the rest of the night. The period is over. Everyone needs a break, including us.
Our scarf tonight is just $10. Hurry, as supplies are limited.
Let's check in at ice level with Ray.
San Jose's going to have to finish this one out shorthanded. They're down a man on the bench, and the injured player will not return.
Period three has started. A lot of goals scored by... He scores! This is unbelievable!
That look of no doubt he was going to score on that breakaway.
Enzo, just because you're in the butterfly doesn't mean you can give in to the shooter. You still have to move. He looked like he thought he was in perfect shape to make the stop and didn't have to move. Bad guess.
Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate.
He keeps winning draws and his team's ahead in the game. He scores! Neely!
This close to the goaltender, the puck on your stick, you got to snap it quick.
He just wasn't able to get over and cover the top of the net. The shot's perfect, it's right in the roof, and the goalie's dejected.
Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play. Face-off win, and now what will they do with it? Number 74,
assisted. And that icing call is negated thanks to the good work by Neely. He scores! He takes one more serving and fills his plate.
A player defenders need to look out for. He has a wicked release, and you can see it on his play. He snaps it home from the low slot.
And so he looks like he's in pretty good positioning here, but he's not able to get his glove low enough to snap this one up.
Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. They've won the faceoff.
Scored by number 74.
Driving toward that net. Score! What a phenomenal night for this guy.
When in doubt, go to the backhand.
The goalie's in pretty good position, but he's guessing along the lines of where the puck's going to go. Really tough to read on the back end.
Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play.
Edmonton's goal, scored by number 74.
Great scoring chance here. Score! He just keeps adding to a memorable night. Another goal.
With the goal scorer right in front, it was tough for the goaltender to pick up the shot off the backhand.
Great effort, just not good enough as the puck beats him. He's that close to a great stop.
Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate.
The Oilers control at center ice. Slid to Larson. Score!
Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play. The Oilers with
with a win at center.
By number 6, Adam Larson, assisted by number 22, by number 27.
In the slot. Score!
Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. The Sharks control from the faceoff.
Look out, the hits are coming.
Pavelski's not very happy after taking that huge hit. He wasn't aware who was around, and he paid the price.
4 minutes, 25 seconds.
Well, he's got to be shaken up on that one. The body check is a solid one. He went down in a heap and slow to his feet.
Over 5 minutes have been played in this, the third period. Edmonton's offense is just overwhelming now, piling up the goals. Side to side they go, trying to generate something. He drives toward the slot. That's a good save and goal. Neely's foiling for a fight here.
He's been looking for somebody to dance with.
He was standing in the lane and got some up.
Perfectly on his stick in that pass from the left wing. Brings a shot. He scores! Second of the game. What a performance. Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play. The Sharks with possession in the defensive zone.
Holds on and gets that whistle.
Hey, Ray, what's going on down there?
There's not many nights a player gets like this where the puck bounces to you and you finish it off every time. These are dream-filled nights.
It is just another in a long line of outstanding games for him, Ray.
His team is ahead in this game, and he's doing a wonderful job. Oh, what a hit! There is a code for these things, and the gloves will come off.
Oh, that was not a good hit at all. Now somebody's coming to the aid of the fallen teammate.
These two teams get together, you can expect.
And this fight is over. What a way to finish it.
It is much better to give than receive. Trust me.
As this fight was going on, the official skated over to both benches and said, that'll be the end of that.
Edmonton's got another win. Oh, and he's hammered.
Was that who I thought hit him?
And a long-awaited whistle. Now they can help him.
Pavelski's injury is apparent as soon as you see this hit. The collision was fierce. The Sharks are down a man on the bench. A player's gone back to the locker room. I'll try and get you some information later.
Edmonton's got that win.
Couture's ailing, but he can't get off the ice. He's going to have to try and finish the shift.
Shot on goal. Score! He's got his second. Edmonton's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. And they won the neutral zone faceoff. You win that. And score! Another goal!
Clearly in some anguish here. He's working his way back to the bench, but he's hurt.
Edmonton's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play.
Is able to move on in. Score! He got iron with that shot.
The Oilers win the draw. What's next?
Couture's
breakaway chance. So we're into the last minute. All is academic here. Score! What a tremendous night for him. Hawaii's faceoff win.
Scored by number 27.
Breakaway. Oh, that's good. Wonderful save. Didn't go for the deep there. Shot. Score! It's his third goal of the game. A hat trick. The Oilers got that faceoff win. Now what?
It's all on his shoulders. Score!
A face-off win. Let's see what develops.
Crashed into him in open ice. He scores! What a night he's having!
They've taken that faceoff between the blue lines and won it.
Zucker's just lost.
Score! He just keeps adding to a memorable night with another goal.
Solid win at center ice. Now what?
Zucker's on the limp after that big...
He scores! There are nights, and then there's tonight forever. He's going to remember this one.
Neutral zone faceoff one. Possession established here.
Zucker's
score! He's got his second of the game. Another face-off win. I wonder what his percentage is now. It's way up. Score! He just keeps adding to a memorable night with another goal. 49 seconds.
They win the draw and will now set up an attack.
Scored by number 22. Assisted by number
22. Can he beat him here? Score! And that is a remarkable 100 goal.
Oilers goal. His 100th of the tournament. Scored by number 27, Milan Lucic. Assisted by number 22.
So ends another game and another telecast. We hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. For Eddie Olchek and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good night.